Let's quickly understand two important thermodynamic terms, fugacity and activity, and why we use them. So first, let's see, what is fugacity? So, fugacity is a corrected pressure that accounts for how real gases deviate from ideal behavior. In simple words, fugacity represents the effective pressure of a real gas. Then fugacity is represented by small f. So let's understand why we use fugacity. So we know that, for an ideal gas, we can write the chemical potential as mu is equal to mu 0 plus RT ln P. But real gases don't behave ideally, because their molecules attract and repel each other. So, to correct this, we replace the actual pressure P with a corrected pressure called fugacity. Thus, for real gases, we can write the chemical potential as mu is equal to mu 0 plus RT ln F. Hence, we can say that fugacity is an effective pressure that gives the same chemical potential as the real gas actually has. Then at very low pressures, gases behave ideally, hence fugacity is equal to pressure, that is F is equal to P, but as pressure increases, molecular interactions become significant, and because of that gases become less ideal, and therefore fugacity becomes smaller than the actual pressure. So, in short, fugacity adjusts the pressure term to account for real gas behavior, allowing us to still use the same thermodynamic equations, which is used for ideal gases. Now let's quickly understand what is activity. So, activity is the effective concentration of a component in a real solution. It tells us how a substance actually behaves compared to how it should behave in an ideal solution. Then it is represented by AI. Now let's understand why we use activity. So we know that, for an ideal solution, we can write the chemical potential of a component I as mu is equal to mu 0 plus RT ln Xi, where Xi is the mole fraction. This means, in an ideal solution, the chemical potential depends only on the concentration or mole fraction of that component. But in real solutions, molecules interact with each other through attraction or repulsion, and their behavior deviates from ideal. So, we use activity AI instead of Xi. Hence, for real solution, chemical potential can be written as mu I is equal to mu I 0 plus RT ln AI. Now, let's see how is activity related to mole fraction. So, the relation between activity and mole fraction is given by the equation as AI is equal to gamma I into Xi. Here, gamma I is the activity coefficient. It measures how much the real solution deviates from ideal behavior. Then if gamma I is equal to 1, the solution behaves ideally, and AI is equal to Xi. And if gamma I is not equal to 1, the solution is non-ideal, showing molecular interactions. So in short, fugacity corrects pressure for real gases, and activity corrects concentration for real solutions, and both terms let us use ideal thermodynamic equations, even when the system behaves non-ideally.